So far, we know that the Pandavas want to be in disguise for the 1 year of exile. Dharmaraya will have one fear about their appearances. So he says, because of me, you all got into trouble. I lost the game of dice and you all have to bear this pain because of it. He says, I am very sad because of this. He will have one more sadness, and that he expresses to Bhima. He says, to Bhima, I am afraid of you. You are so short-tempered. If someone gets into trouble with you, you kill. If anyone comes to fight with you, you hammer them down. You have a lot of strength. A person who has lot of strength or is very strong can be mild, but you are short-tempered. When you might get mad is unpredictable. So in disguise, if you don't control yourself and go smash somebody, the enemies will come to know that you are Bhima. So if they find out that it is you, then we will have to escape. So this is a big problem. Then Bhima apologizes and says, no, I will not do such things. So the plan is, he says, we all must be in disguise together in a village, but far enough that we are not too far to find each other. Second sadness that Dharmaraya has is, he says, you all lived like kings and now in the forest with the sages, and now we will be in Virat Raja's kingdom and under his control. We have to go fall to his feet and ask for jobs, and then we have to accept whatever he offers and spend 1 year. So that saddens me and I feel for you all, he says. Now they have to serve other people. They must have a serving attitude. Look, even if you are anywhere else where you work, you are still servant of the government. Orders come and you will get transferred. There is a saying in English, uneasy lies ahead, that wears the crown. That means the sword is always over the person who wears the crown. You never know when that sword may strike you. Therefore, there is always danger. Dharmaraya says, all five of us will go in different disguise. We will behave like we are not related to each other. Even work-wise also, we will do different types of jobs. Dharmaraya says, look, I will go in the disguise of a Brahmin and my name will be Kankabhatta. He says, I will tell the king that I am Kankabhatta. I am very much needed by the Pandavas. He knows that Virata likes Pandavas, therefore he plans this way. They all went away to exile. Therefore, I have come to your kingdom. If you give me my work, I will do that work with extreme care. Virata gets carried away by his servitude and he is very surprised that too, after hearing that this person is in front of him, is close to Pandavas. So, Virata asks Dharmaraya, what work will you do? Dharmaraya says, I will be with you, the king, and give you advice whenever you want. I will be doing the work the king gives me. I will read the scriptures. If anybody is ready to play dice with me, I will also play dice with them. This way, he says, everything that he wants to the king. To spend time and kill time, playing that game of dice is the best thing to do. Besides that, he says, I will do other type of help too. He says, I have lots of in-depth knowledge of Dharma Shastra and I will chant them for you. Like this, he tells everything to Virata. You see, there is a post called personal secretary. For the officers, There will be a personal secretary. His work is to do whatever the officer asks him to do. That work Dharmaraya takes for himself. His imagination is for 1 year he can live doing this work without any problems. Since he will be with the king himself, no one will know who he is. Virata thinks, man, this person is good and he has the knowledge. He talks well. So he says, I'll give you the job of personal secretary. His work is not hard. He just have to come to the palace every day, and also he has to come to the assembly, and when the king is bored, he will tell stories, give advice to do when enemies attack. Therefore, he feels this person is a good fit and employs Dharmaraya. Now his name is Kankabhatta. Always remember this name. Who is Kankabhatta? Kanka in Sanskrit means Yama. His father is Yama. He was born as a result of Yama's boon. His father is Yama and therefore he names himself Kankabhatta. Kankabhatta means nobody will recognize him, and that too he assumed a Brahmin name and no one will ever recognize him as a Kshatriya. He applies Vibhuti to his forehead and says the mantras, and so no one will doubt him. He learned the Shastra so well that no one will doubt him that he is a Kshatriya. He had practiced it well and so he had no trouble saying the Shastras. So he joined work, and after some days Bhima comes. Bhima comes and says, in the kitchen I had a big job. I have left that job, and if you want, I can work in the kitchen. I will do the cooking, and along with that, I also know some boxing. So if anybody is against you, he says to Virata, I can fight them. So I can fight as well as cook. So if the enemies attack, I will step up to win. So like this, he also joins work. So he joins work as a kitchen cook or the head cook. Kitchen in the palace is very big. In a day, they will have to feed about 2,000 people. Soldiers, officials, relatives and everybody else in the palace need food. So that responsibility is always there, and it has to also go to the king's quarters. All this work, he says, I will take care. Pampa also has written the Mahabharata, and there Bhima says, Virata Raja, please listen to me. If I cook in my kitchen, there is just not flavor, but you will never get bored. Every day, the food will have different flavors. You will find that there will always be flavors all the time. So now, Bhima gets the job. Dharmaraya has no relation to what he is doing or what Bhima work is. Then Arjuna comes. This Arjuna was cursed by Urvashi to be a inak. Therefore, he wants to make use of this curse for this 1 year. So for that 1 year, he decides to be in the disguise of a woman. So he comes as a woman, and when he comes, he says that he has a liking to give dance lessons to the women. So, if you teach dance to the women, the princesses actually, they will be very happy and they will want to learn dance. So, he says, I will live here to teach dance as a dance teacher. He says he wants to be a guru. So, Virata asks his wife what she thinks of this idea, and she likes it a lot. So, she says, why not our princesses need dance lessons? And if she can teach dance, then I will be very happy. So Inak in disguise comes and offers to teach dance in the disguise of a woman, and nobody rejects this offer. So one person is with the king, the other is in the kitchen, and Arjuna is a dance teacher. None of these roles are related. The king will have a dance theater, and there they give Arjuna a place to teach in the dancing hall. The king says there are lots of princesses. Please teach them all how to dance. Next, Nakula comes. Nakula loves horses, making them run, polishing them, getting them ready for the war. Also, getting the horses ready to ride. He says, I like horses, therefore I will take care of them, says Nakula. Not just that, I will see to it that they don't fall sick. Everybody will talk about your horses in the kingdom. I will take care of them so well. So, he was also hired for this job. Sahadeva comes next. He says, I like to herd cows. Taking care of the cows is what I like. I like to take care of their health. I like to choose good cows, bullocks for plowing, and this way he expresses his wishes. No one finds any wrong with this, so he is also hired for this job. So there is no relation between horses and cows now. And Nakula and Sahadeva will never talk to each other. Draupadi, without the knowledge of anybody, goes straight to the king's quarters. There, Keechaka's sister Sudeshne was there. She is Virata's wife and Keechaka's sister. She is also a queen. Someone gives her a news that a girl is coming towards the palace and that she is very beautiful. Even if Draupadi disguises herself, she cannot hide her beauty. So they say she is coming and she is walking towards the palace. She is very beautiful to look at and she will make you happy, they say to Sudeshna. So Sudeshne is like, who is this? I need to see her and meet her. So they invite her to the palace. They see her with lots of respect and then Draupadi says, I have 5 husbands. They are all gods. They have disguised themselves. They are in the heavens abode. They will not come here. They had work, therefore they have gone for 1 year. So for the next 1 year, I have to live here. They are all in work and I will have to stay here for 1 year. And then I will return back. So Sudeshna asks, what will you do? She says, I like to dress up girls and I know that work very well. I will comb the queen's hair. Every day I will dress them different styles. I will do any kind of hairstyling. Also, I will also do other work that you might give me. Any small work also, you can give me and I will do it. Now, this kind of work is also called Sanchi. A person who serves drinks, water, etc. She says, I will take the work. Since it was a palace, princesses were never let outside and also no men were allowed to. Therefore, Virata's wife keeps Draupadi there. We will see what happens next.